it's hard to get people into movie theaters. So there's a lot of competition, you know, it's very hard to book a theater. So we really tried to get people of stature that could speak of Yogananda. And what we discovered, so we did, you know, we got a professor of theology at Harvard, we went to Deepak Chopra, we went to a physicist and a physician who taught at Harvard and also at MIT.
Krishna Das. Right, big bhakti.
And we also went to people that had a popular following, like Krishna Das.
And also there were archival interviews, you know, with George Harrison, who was, you know, very, very devoted to Yogananda, and Ravi Shankar, and some other people, you know, a lot of people in the late 60s and early 70s, for them, that Yogananda was their doorway, their point of entry into Eastern mysticism. And so many people read that book, including Steve Jobs, you know, who we mentioned in the film too, that was one of his favorite books. He read it once a year. So we needed these points of entry to entice outsiders to say, oh, if these people like think that Yogananda has something to say, I want to pay attention now, you know?
Because the real knowledge of Yogananda actually was the scholars at Self-Realization Fellowship had a tremendous amount of knowledge about what happened throughout the years in establishing his organization in America. And so we were very lucky in being able to interview and really the doors were open to us at Self-Realization Fellowship. But we really went beyond that as well. We really wanted to know, what does the world know about Yogananda and how did he influence people like George Harrison and these other figures? So I think the timing of when the film came out ended up being perfect, even though for us it was a little bit torturous because it took forever to make the film. But the timing was such where even Steve Jobs' death really brought a lot of attention to The Autobiography of a Yogi being the seminal book that he gave out to people in his at his funeral.